And if anybody objects to being filmed, recorded, or whatever? No? Alright. Everybody interest? No? Any comments on the last week? Any massive comments over there?
Okay.
Okay, Simon?
Agreed.
Okay, and we have got a couple of apologies tonight. Apologies to Ian Burris and Councillor Stevens is deputising Chris Bakley, and Councillor Denise Roberts is deputising Pat Crossman. Okay, that leads us to item 3, and last remarks, Councillor Stevens.
Thank you, Chair. The purpose of this report was to ask members to consider the criteria for granting a private hire or happy carriage driver licence to an applicant who has failed to renew their licence on or before the renewal date. Members will be aware that before granting a private hire or happy carriage driver licence, the council must be satisfied that the applicant is a fit proper person to hold such a licence and also be authorised to drive a motor vehicle for at least 12 months. Set out in paragraph 2.3 is the criteria that must be met when a new applicant comes for such a licence. These tests are considered necessary, taking into account the safety of passengers and the nature of the work undertaken by a private hire or rapid carriage driver. Drivers are required to renew their licence on or before the expiry date, and members will be aware that we do set out renewal letters to drivers a month before the expiry date to advise them of this. What members are asked to consider is that there can be circumstances whereby a driver who has been licensed for a period of time then fails to renew within that time. And what members are asked to consider is to recognise the circumstances that are associated with the fact that somebody has held a licence and therefore been known to us as a driver, and therefore we would have a record relating to that driver. For example, if there had been any incidents, possibly even complaints or anything at all, that would be attached to their record. And indeed, if there was any concerns regarding that driver, they would have been brought before the licensing panel at that time. So what members are asked to consider circumstances for a driver who does cause no concern to the licensing office for those reasons, but will have failed to renew, that in those circumstances where the licensed driver fails to renew and submits an application for a new license within a period of 7 days, starting with the day after the license expires, that officers be delegated to grant a new license if the following criteria is met. And that is that they have a satisfactory driving license in terms of making sure that there are no points exceeding the normal points that before it would be brought before a licensing panel. That they have got the qualification either the DRQ or the NDQ, that they have passed the knowledge test, and that a valid DBS or criminal record check has been issued within the previous 3 years in accordance with the requirement for drivers who are currently licensed, and that they undertake a medical in accordance with the requirement for drivers who are currently licensed. Therefore, if they were due a medical, then they would be expected to have that medical before the license is issued.
Okay, any questions?
Interesting. Brief one really, it's on 2.9, it says 7 day period. The 7 day period, and it's from wrong work to, it's not a 7 day work, 7 day work, it is 7 days.
That's correct, and in that, for a licensed driver, they do work 7 days, they can work over 7 days, so Sundays and Saturdays would be normal working, so we feel that 7 day period is quite clear. No argument or dispute about whose working days, the working days of the licensing office or the working days.
careful. The licensing manager mentioned that it would be 7 days. Most licenses finish at midnight, and that can be Saturday or Sunday. So there's the 7 day period proposed to start at midnight, as opposed to, because you did say the next day.
They have conditions on their license, and their license says you
need to meet him. This will give them a bit of leeway. We had stuff in front of us as a panel that involved in getting weddings and all sorts of stuff, and agreements and everything else, and we've been very lenient with them. But that, oh, I forgot ones, or I didn't get the letter ones, are the ones we need to actually start cracking down on. And whilst I'm quite happy with the recommendation subject to refusing delegating to officers, this happened. There is a line now, and it's a real hard time as far as I'm personally concerned, because when it comes down to it, yes, I understand the agreement, and that's fine. But we need to be saying that the licensing committee is taking it.
Councillor, I'm just glancing at the appendix of the next report. Is there a fee for a renewal?
The license fee is the same. An application involves a £10 application fee and £44,000 criminal check fee. But if they were having a criminal record check done, at the union would still have to pay that extra £44 as well.
I'm just wondering, is there any more extra work involved for this new proposed system than that? So I'm just wondering whether it is in this report or the next report, we might be suggesting that we should be instituting a fee.
I think it is a very valid point, please, Chair. I think because there is, as you see in the table of fees, that there is an application fee of £10, which is for the funds of the new license. And I would say, unless members consider differently, because it is a new application fee, a new application, and they would have to pay that fee.
So there will be a
yeah. Okay. We'll go back to everybody. Item 3, have we agreed on that? Any more questions for the grade? Okay. Sorry, Chair, subject to
agree
with the officers.
Yeah. Chair, if you can include in that. They will be subject to £10 current fee, whether that is at that time,
yes.
Or a new application.
Yes. Okay. Yes. So,
Green.
Item 4.
Can you just go on that? I think that you brought that up on the post as well. It's going to be a penalty for an economy to say, well, you know, you didn't come here, you still got to pay.
Yeah.
I mean, it's like also if we go and do something on our outside, there's a penalty for everything.
That's right.
And that combines.
Yeah, hard.
The passport was a very good one. Marvellous.
Okay. Yes, thank you, Chair. The purpose of this report is to ask members to set the fees for the, obviously, the administration of the licence fees across the board in terms of private hire and carriage. License fees and operator fees. There is a requirement for us to set these on an annual basis, and what I do each year is to review the costs of the service against the income that we receive from the fees that we administer. And you'll see from the report that there is a projected surplus of just over £2,000 in this year's budget, which really would merit the fees staying as they are. If there was to have been a huge surplus in our income, then we would have had to reflect that in the fees that we set for the coming year, and that would mean that we would have had to reduce the fees. If there was a huge deficit, or you know, a significant deficit, where we don't feel that we would recover, and by keeping the fees the same, then we would have to increase those fees. But in view of the current, as I say, projected out of the budget, I would recommend that we keep the fees the same as they are currently.
Okay, any questions on that?
Just one. It's just that we've Wirral, but this story got out to the trailer.
Yes, well, it was circulated. I did mention to them at the last JCC a few weeks ago that we would be bringing a report to you.
There's no representation here this evening.
No.
So I think they, you know, if there's something they're not agreeing with, they're agreeing without full contingency here tonight. So I can't see a problem with this.
Just to follow up on that comment, I have the wonderful duty of chairing the JCC.
I don't agree.
At the moment, I'm in the. And they did kick off, so that's right. I'm interested that there's been a small surplus within the. And I'm just wondering about the possibilities, and I appreciate to you, Chair, that staffing issues within the licensing department, but whether or not, if and when new members of staff are replaced, because they're about to be, that might be used up. Therefore, the fees might be too low, if it's your name, because I appreciate that staff obviously were hamstrung and not necessarily good with their fees.
What was happening in those circumstances in that children who were the company who are by full services wouldn't have to subject to the review at the moment? And should that then affect the cost of our service? Then we would actually rent that in the fees next year. Currently, as I say, that those fees are based on staffing commitments that we do have at the moment and the representative, including costs attributed by the solicitor and Mr. Carter, licensing company. So we incorporated those costs into that. At the end of the next financial year that we will review again, if there was a deficit, we would need to increase the fees to recover that deficit.
Okay. Just wondered whether you needed to reflect our discussion of the last item in this appendix.
Yes,
okay.
That's helpful.
Fine, that's okay.
Okay.
Any more questions?
Quite reasonable to be able to do that.
Is everybody okay? Is anything else, Mark? I just want to touch on one thing, and I'll keep it a couple of minutes. You may not have seen in the press the advert coverage about it. And Martin, and I'm sorry about this, Mark, but you can just go to me. You may have seen that Maisie Travel is sponsoring this training for the ambassadors and women. They're expecting 2.5 million, isn't it? We're expecting 2.5 million this summer in tourism. And they've done this training at the Games, it's called the Wirral Coast Training, and was introduced last week, the first one here. And I went down on some of the taxi officers on the river and explained to the taxi officers why it's important. When people arrive here, we get the right first time, and want people to have a friendly approach and say to the friends, family, we'll come back to the river and maybe start again. And it's been quite good, that's one of the take up on that. I just gave the taxi driver, just there.
Yeah, I mean, we have tried to start with the operators and the persons, because obviously they have good communication at the drivers. But we have also spoken through the JCC to the representatives of Hand and Trade. We do need to get the message out better to them. So we have actually been preparing this afternoon a news letter to the drivers. The funding for this training is only open until June, possibly July. So it's just a small window to
Patrick's interested, about council interest, and not council ideas, about couple of owners interested. Because it's open to everybody.
Watch music yesterday in this garden. I just encourage them as well to send their stuff. Because you can go online and book whatever you want. There is a taxi one which we're trying to make it more bespoke to taxi drive. So they feel it's relevant, you know, what's relevant to somebody working in a hotel and the way they sort of maybe approach people and have the conversation. It's not quite a conversation with taxi driver can have one in the morning sometimes. So we don't want to be sort of, you know, glib in terms of doing that, you know, training. So we do really want as many to come. We've got two sessions next week. So if you're using taxis and you want to encourage them, please do.
I'm told by Charlie Norman at the 18th this week, would it be helpful if members of the committee tonight get the information on the link? And if you want to pass it on to any people you know in various businesses, that the opportunities there, can you do that?
Yeah.
To all members and deputies.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah.
I mean, they can choose to go on to the other modules. Some of the modules are for a day, but it's entirely, you know, voluntary. I mean, it would be wonderful to have, you know, I mean, we are first to go for a certain city region in terms of, you know, there are some operators who want to be able to describe themselves as well as those deliverers. So that if they get half their staff,
Thanks for your time, and that's it.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.